Alright, let's get down with our bad selves, shall we? That's right, we're going into biker mode. Yeah. Now, I've scouted out a location here. Looking at the biker clubs. Now, this one's over on Del Perro, on the beach. It's close to my CEO office, close to one of my apartments. Kind of nice, and the price is good. It's not the best, not the best priced one. I mean, if you go up here, you know, you're talking 200 grand. Not bad. 210 there, 225. Like, the further you go up, let's see, these get a little more expensive because they're probably on the highway and stuff. Thought about getting one by my apartment up here, but I just think it kind of fits. Now, you get down here where you're deep in the heart of the city. And this, I think, relates to how far away you are from the stuff that you have to do. So I think a good bargain here is about $365,000. Not sure I'm going to make the purchase just yet. Let's try it. Come on. Do it. Because, you know, there's all the options that go on. Like, you know, first of all, you got your mural. That's not bad, but it's like, okay, there's a small biker with a giant woman. I don't know exactly what that means. It's just, you know, Route 68, that's kind of classic, very American. Home of the brave and the barely clothed women. Yes, it's... Okay, that's just disgusting. Now, here you go, you got a GTA Vice City throwback, but still kind of odd. That's kind of pleasant, you know? The open road, yes, this is what it's all about right there. Ride forever! Okay, I kind of like where they're going with this, but, you know, still. No, I like it, but no. Let's see. We are the mods. That's what the whole thing. I guess if you were gonna do, just basically a British biker kind of thing, take off there on the '60s. There's a whole story about those. You could go that route. I don't know. This is good. That's free. It's free and there's semi-nudity, which this is $112,000 for. Let's go stock for the time being. I think you can change it later. Style, no, it's like, all right, well, if you change the wall style, which makes it, seems like it just changes the floor style. It's $138,000 for new carpet. Wall hanging, 98 grand to put a couple neons up. And slightly better furniture, 164,000. I think none of that's going to matter for right now, no. Club emblem? There you go. Now there's a story of this club emblem. Once upon a time, there was a game called Freelancer. And I played it on a server called the Get On It server. Later called the Aussie Freelancer server, which would have been useful to me at the beginning, because then I would have known it was an Australian server and my ping would be over 200. However, then I would have missed out, because this is one of the best role-playing servers of any game I've ever seen in the world. It was fantastic. We had cops, we had drug smugglers, we had pirates, we had crazed people who just randomly shoot at you, we had psychopaths, and then we had my clan, the base clan. The base clan was pretty much the anti-griefing clan. Whenever people would start griefing people, we would try to hunt them down. And it wasn't that we were so good that we would kill these people, but then they would grief us, and then the other people would get away. We kind of made ourselves targets, and after a while, we got to be pretty good. You know, at one point, we even took the, both us and our allies, at separate points, held the central system, but that's another story for another day. The reason I'm telling you this story is that, in reference to the whole gorilla thing, is that once upon a time, our allies, the Draco clan, a clan of extremely cool cats from New Zealand, came up with the idea that, hey, maybe we would like to let off some steam too, and we knew most of the people in the game, we weren't going to grief newbies or something like that, but it would be good to, you know, let off some steam with all the people who are, you know, griefing us or fooling around with us. We had a fool around night. We wanted to step out of character. Step out of the white knight, or in my case, the black knight, character roles, and fly around and mess with people. So to do this, they came up with an incredible story. And I have to tell you, on this server, you had a clan, but you also, people used to write stories about their clans and post them on the forums. You know, they called them neural nets, which comes from this whole thing here, this whole, your neural net log, which doesn't show anything here, because it's the multiplayer side of things. But the idea was we'd write our own stories, our own diary, our own ship's log of what was going on. And, you know, I had a bunch of them. Everybody had a bunch of them. I picked it up from what other people were doing and actually got me into writing. But that's another story for another day. Again, I'm getting sidetracked. But Grisha came up with this story that one of his guys, and I'd have to look it up which guy it was, who was their scientist, was experimenting with genetically modified gorillas. Where they got gorillas, I don't know, because the whole premise of this was that there were sleeper ships that were sent from Earth because, you know, they were losing the war and blah, blah, blah. So, I don't know, maybe they had some gorilla DNA somewhere on one of the ships. They found this, made some gorillas. It's not important to the story. This was supposed to be silly anyway. But the idea was that he had like a couple hundred of these genetically modified gorillas who were supposed to be made smart enough to fly our ships for us so that they could do our work. Kind of like Age of Ultron, only not with gorillas instead of a robot, that kind of thing. And of course the gorillas escape and they take our ships and then they go around and mess with people. And just to solidify the theme of this, we created new ships just for the occasion with the tags Ook Ook, which idea is that the monkeys had retagged the ships. And so we were Clan Ook Ook, and we would just go around and attack people. When they'd say, "Why are you attacking me?" we'd say, "Ook Ook. Ook, 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 ook." And we'd fly around just randomly in system check, like, "Ook, ook, 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 ook," because we were gorillas. It's just, you know, monkeys, gorillas, the whole... We didn't really research exactly what sound a gorilla would properly make, whether ook is really more of a monkey thing or a gorilla thing, which, again, not important, really, to the part of the story. And so we flew around, and it was really kind of a quiet night. We mostly just flew around looking for people saying ook. We did find, I think, a couple people, but, you know, this is a big system map, and you can kind of, you can see, there's a lot of places, it's hard to find just one bird. You have to go throughout New York, and then someone else will go here, and you chase them around. We had a lot of fun doing it. We only did it for a couple of nights, I think. Only a few nights. I think I was only involved in a couple of nights. Because, again, it was like, well, yeah, that was fun. But we kept the joke going. Oh, to this day, I'll still, you know, leave chat with one of the base guys, and we'll say, "Hey, have a good night, ook ook." It's kind of an inside the base sort of thing. Well, now you know about it. If we could get everybody saying ook ook, that'd be wonderful. But so now, fast forward to the present day GTA 5. Right now, I'm going to start a motorcycle gang, a gang of people who do bad things and largely grief the world. Not really fitting in with the base character of things here. No, it really isn't. So, what better thing to do than to pay homage to that wonderful event than to update the base graphics to the defaulted monkey graphic or gorilla graphic in there, and to name the club the Ook Ook Club. And right now, this is a gratuitous visual of a Titan landing here in Cadiz. A pirate base. And from one pirate base to another, all you need to know is that this is not Harambe. Okay? We're going to leave that club name. Motorcycle Club. Yeah, let's see. How we call it? Club Ook Ook. That sounds more like a bar. MC Ook Ook? MC Ook Ook. That sounds like it's like, "What up, yo? I'm MC Ook Ook." Let's just call it Ook Ook. I think I could change it in any time anyway. 1, 2. 10. Ook. That looks pretty freelancery, as I recall. We might go with this. That's font one. We're back around. Gunlocker. It's only 300. No. And the custom bike shop. No, we're not even doing that. We're not engaging the custom bike shop. Because apparently the custom bike shop doesn't have really anything to offer except convenience. And, you know, we're not that far away from the other place. So what we're going to do is we're going to buy Club Ook Ook. We're gonna make it happen. Buy that sucker! Congratulations, return to the map. Close out here. You're now the president of Ook Ook. And we should be able, there we go. Well, the main benefits is it does act as another garage.
Yo, good to see y'all. I'm out, over from LC, looking after these joints. You taking over this clubhouse? Alright. I guess you're gonna be starting some kind of MC chapter of your own. This got all the recreational facilities your crew gonna want. Darts, juke, arm wrestling table, working bar, whatever. Yo, you gotta invite some prospects, get them to join the club, then you lay down the hierarchy. You usually need like a VP, a road captain, a sergeant at arms, definitely an enforcer, you know, something like that. Each role got its own perks and its own responsibilities. Hey, it's good to keep shit organized, because there's jobs out there folks will pay an OMC to do. Get them out of trouble with the 5-0, run protection, make hits, you know, whatever. Work goes up on the board, and you can take it if you want it. What else you need to know? There's plenty of room to store your bikes. Every club member gets a spot. If y'all want to set up a bike shop, we can make that happen. You gotta pay for the work, though, on all those rides. But it's all good, because you got a cat on site. There's a spot where a gun locker can go, should y'all need the artillery stored in the building. And then we got a PC back here on an anonymity network. Ha! You seen that shit? The feds don't pick you up. You can hook it up with these internet cats to run illicit businesses. Take a look at that shit. For real. You'll thank me. And that's that, baby. I'll be in touch if you're taking any of that club business. Otherwise, enjoy the place.
So here we are. We've got our own... Oh, here we go.
Yo, you the cat that took the clubhouse out of receiver shit? I'm like the manager caretaker. Swing by the joint and I'll talk you through a few things.
That happened backwards. Well, hey, all right. We've got some... So here we are. Look around. Okay, that's a vivid image. That's got my picture up on the wall here. Yo. Other pictures up on the wall. We got darts going. And somewhere out here we got the bike. Okay, let's see. Invite to clubhouse. No available players. Well, okay, we have to wait for them to... I wonder if that's a permanent thing or if it's the kind of dealio where once I make somebody a veep, they're a veep. Because that's how I'd like it to be. Can you actually sleep here? You can sleep here. Got some posters on the wall. Sure, some of these are of significance. You could change your outfits? Yep, change clothes. It's like having another apartment. Only for bikes. Now, we'll sit down here at the table. Now, why am I keeping my helmet on? That's just, I'm so biker, I guess. And let's see. Oh, you can't get to the network. You have to be in a public session. See, now that's one of the downsides. You can't do these missions. You can't do those missions, at least the business missions, in a solo session like I am now. And what's... Oh, we got a bathroom. All right. And can you use the bathroom? I realize it's my club. But I don't know that I'd want to use this bathroom. That's pretty hardcore right there. Wow. Phew. Yeah, we'll go back to the apartment. It's not that far away. But the... Oh, I see. It's a foreground vector. No, it's still a biker driving in front of a giant woman. This is... There's some symbolic stuff going here. I'm absolutely sure of it. And, you know, no point in trying to look behind the biker. It's a 2D image. Let's go outside. Let's bring up our other bike. I only have the two bikes as of yet. Let's see if we can put two bikes in here. That's the vehicle management menu one. Okay. How many bikes can we manage? We got a lot of bike storage here. That's a good thing. Lots of bike storage is the point. I still know how to get out. Is it walk up to the door and you'll let you out? Or? There you go. All right. So you call up. We got text. Simeon, I got no time for you. Managing my bikes.
Day two.
Okay. Been a little busy here in the meantime, but we got some stuff moved around. As you can see, I now have got the official Pogo the Space Monkey mask, which goes along with the whole theme of being, you know, the whole crazed gorillas from outer space kind of thing. Got my bikes moved up. I got, of course, the Hakachu over here. That's my main bike. This is just a collector's edition kind of deal, as far as I'm concerned. The Damon with the Lost. This one was actually stolen, so that's a stole it from a lost member. I think that's a good thing. Now this is, of course, the Nightjade, the Western Nightjade, and you have to buy the Western Nightjade in the limited period of time to get the free T-shirt. We have to go get our free T-shirt yet. It's not in my inventory right now. I'm wearing my Bahama Mama's T-shirt, but we'll have to go get that. And I've done it up. It's not really even close there. You can't see it in this light. We'll take it outside. It's a really complex red with some decorations on it to try and mimic the Nightmare, of course, which is a real bike, a real one-of-a-kind bike, which I have actually sat on. It was created by one of my clients, and you've seen other pictures of it before in previous videos, but that's why I'm trying. It hasn't got a long enough set of spokes, not nearly enough chrome, but it is the Nightshade, so I'm calling it the Nightmare, like a Nightshade. Kind of, you know where I'm going with that. And now this, you'll notice I had to get the Faggio mod here just because of, again, of Jeremy Clarkson. This is, you know, as close as I could make it to the bike that Jeremy Clarkson rode through Vietnam. That's pretty close. I'm not sure. I think the mirror layout isn't exactly the same, but that's pretty close. The color layout's not quite the same because of the way they do the secondary and primary colors. But that's still pretty close there. But, and of course, these two bikes now, you know, let's take this one out. We'll take the Nightjade. Even though I have no performance mods on it, at least you'll get to see the look of the thing in the sunshine. That's not. That's. I didn't modify the tank. I did give it a saber front fender. Again, it's a very stealthy, dark sort of. But I like the way that came out, though. I like the way that looks. Eventually, we'll have this all performance hopped up. So let's see. Should we get our free T-shirt? Where's the clothes? We got people right around us here. Maybe we should try a mission. Let's see. I'm almost broke. As you can see, look at $13,000 just from that bike was $100,000. But which seems like a lot, but it's really not. Consider that the moped was $55,000, and of course, then there is the attendant mods to them. Let's go back in over here. We do have a bartender. What's up? What up, yo? You don't even talk, do you? Okay. Okay, it's nice to have you here. Okay, that's... let's see. Where's the back room here where we can do our dealings? Here's, of course, the boardroom. With the new base logo, which looks like we spilled paint because it doesn't quite have the resolution that you'd hope for. I don't even know which way is up on that, but that's, we have a boardroom. Can sit down different places, have meetings. That's probably the front door. Where is my computer and such? That's kind of what we need. Still learning the layout here, gang. Please be patient with me. Let's just find our computer. Boop. That's the bathroom. We've been in here before. You, yes. So that's the bathroom. All right, there's the computer here in our back room. Now we're in a regular session, so we should be able. We should be able to at least look at the businesses. I want to talk about the businesses and why I'm not buying any just yet. There's a reason.
Greetings, new user. The wonders of modern technology have gifted us a small oasis in this desert of our surveillance state. This brief respite from the x-ray gaze of civil servants, spooks, and spouses. So, let's use it to make as much moolah as we can. Should you like, I can help you produce, market, and sell quality counterfeit documents. Unimpeachable fake cash. Dank-ass marijuana. Moorish methamphetamine. Or your realtor's favorite cocaine. With my vast knowledge and your time, effort, and bank, we'll be unstoppable. Please be advised, only one business of each type can be owned. Resupplies and sales are your responsibility. Administrative fees will be charged for every transaction, and your business may draw unwanted attention from law enforcement or other malefactors, but that's half the fun. Message me for further details. Your friend, Long John Teabag.
Now, Long John Teabag supposedly is actually Lester using a voice changer. You can hear a little bit of Lester in there, can't you? And at some point they say a couple of things. He actually almost says Lester. He goes, it's Lester Long John Teabag. So that's Lester working things from a different angle here. Now, as you can see, I have nowhere near enough money to buy any of these, which is not why I'm not buying them just yet. You can, the way this works is you buy a business, and then you have to get, you have to supply it, which means you have to spend $75,000 on top of this, or you have to do a mission to go steal them, which is usually a bit better if you have a whole bunch of people going with you. You have to steal it from other bikers, whether it's documents, like blank documents for your forgeries, or stuff so you could grow weed, counterfeit cash, you can make, you know, ingredients for your meth, or the basic stuff for your cocaine. And you can make a lot of money doing this stuff. The missions seem like they go along a similar path to the CEO missions where they send you, they give you the packages, you have to deliver them. You either have to go out and get the stuff, bring it back, and then wait some time for the stuff to mature and the stuff to be produced, and then sell the product someplace. And you get more money the further away the location is. And it's very straightforward, and there's different, you know, oh, I have to, you know, someone's taking your stuff, go get them kind of things. There's different kind of missions that go along with it. It's very similar to the CEO. They say the CEO, you make more money. The real trick with these are, number one, I don't think you can sell a business. I don't think you can get rid of it. You can get rid of it by having it taken over by the cops, then you lose your business. That's one of the dangers. You can invest all this money, and if the cops show up, you have to reset it up again by the location, I believe, buy all the equipment, the whole nine yards. So it's, or at least you lose a significant part of your investment. You have to reset things up. So that's one danger. The other danger is for every business, you can have one of each of these. It costs about $6,000 per day. That's your daily the daily cost and maintenance. Which, I mean, you have employees here, so it does make some sense. But if you're not really into it and you don't have like a real crew going with you on these things, and this isn't what you're really into, then that's not what you should do initially, because you're going to have to, you know, make you might want to pick one, see if you like doing the missions, and then at least you only have to, you know, I don't know, find $5,000 or $6,000 just to keep it going if you're not that there. The one way you can get around paying the taxes, oddly enough, is to turn on your CEO, be a CEO, and then it turns, for some reason, it turns off the taxes on these things. I don't know if that's going to be patched or if it's going to stay the same. I mean, but at least right now we have a way out. If you feel like, well, I'm not using this and I don't be a CEO. Now, being a CEO is expensive. You need a couple million for that. works for me because I am a CEO. But we're not going to do the open road yet. I am tempted to get a business at some point. I'm thinking document forgery would be kind of fun. I don't think it's the most profitable. The most profitable is definitely cocaine. I think it's either cocaine or methamphetamine. But if you're looking for straight money, you're better off doing the CEO stuff, which one of the tricks about these things, too, is all the missions have to be done in a public session. So with the same problem with the CEO missions, you're still going to run into people flying around in fighter jets bombing the crap out of you just to grief you. So that's another reason we're going to avoid the open road. And let's see. But that doesn't mean there's nothing we can do here. Let's see. Let's go find the jobs board. There's supposed to be a board of jobs. Let's see. Where's our organizational board of thingies to do? There's a place. There's somewhere in here we could get jobs.
The president of the motorcycle club.
Thanks, Cindy. Cindy, where the heck are my jobs? I know there's supposed to be a wall of missions. We got a jukebox. Let's see, is it? No, did I miss it somewhere back? It's kind of dim. Kind of dim in here. But there's supposed to be missions you can do somewhere. And they're taped up on the wall. Those are just cool signs. What's
Hi
in
there,
here?
President.
Maybe in the boardroom. Aha! Yes, here we are in the boardroom. This is our mission planning area. Let's see if we can sell clubhouse contracts. POW. Let's see, Zoom. Favorite format. This is interesting. You got stats up here. Call Crystal. We should try that at some point. Try that. Stolen. Let's try. So can we do that? I think we can. Let's write that, some of those down. We'll come back to this. Peter wanted rescue operation. Some fool got himself in trouble. Payment when he walks to freedom. How do I select? POW rescue. He accidentally selected one. All right, so we gotta exit the clubhouse. Rescue the client. This is probably something that would have been easier had we had multiple people. We're going to see if we can solo this, just as a test.
Cool. You down for this rescue operation? The dude's being held over in Grape Seed by some crystal cooks. Cheaper to pay you than pay them. So get him out.
Oh, we're getting email from LJT who wants to know when we're going to have a, when we're going to start setting up a business. Go to the O'Neill's Ranch. Oh, goodness. We got to shoot the O'Neill's up? Now, for those of you who don't remember, we haven't done the single player, stuff on here. If you haven't done the single player mission, then you don't know the O'Neills. The O'Neills are a bunch of hillbillies out in the middle of nowhere that later on Trevor just kills all of them and burns their place to the ground. And they're meth dealers. And they're not nice people. So getting somebody from the O'Neills, this is not something you could feel like it's necessarily a bad guy thing to do. It's bad guys versus bad guys. Definitely glad I took the fast bike. This is going to take us a little ways to ride out there. So let's do the time warp again, shall we? I do think it's a little disrespectful to call this a POW mission. I mean, this is one gang member being held by a bunch of meth people. I don't know if that really... That's kind of inappropriate, ladies and gentlemen. But it is what it is, and we're just going to deal with that as it comes. I guess one of the things you're going to notice about all of the biker stuff is that there's a lot of just driving. Lots of it. There's lots of long-distance driving in the game, which I guess makes sense. But, yeah. But I'm not going to make you watch it all. Okay, at least we're getting closer here now. Yeah, I think we're definitely closing on it. Maybe? No, you got a little ways to go yet. To go in here. I wonder if I'll have to kill them all, or just get the guy. Is it going to be a stealth mission? Is it going to be a going guns a blazing thing? I'm not very stealthy, but here we are. Ah, yes, the O'Neill's Ranch. I'm thinking that, I don't know. Okay, we won't kick off. Oh, wait a minute. There we go. I see O'Neill's. Excuse me, O'Neill's. I'm thinking. That maybe we want to, you know, weaken things up a little bit here.
Ah, you're dead.
Where are they hiding now?
Fucker.
Anybody else outside? At least somebody's shooting at me.
Die, die, die.
Oh, they're beating on the client? Where is the client? Client health is going down.
Dead, dead, dead.
And, oh, I minimized my...
Shit!
You played it, asshole!
That sounds like a shotgun. How many times do we have to kill all these rednecks, you know? Okay, we got that guy, we got that guy.
Bleeding, asshole!
Closed door, is that the...
Motherfucker!
Oh, damn!
You must be lost, friend.
Ah,
oh my god!
It's the client?
Much appreciated.
Escape the farmhouse, so we can do that.
You going down?
Can you jump over that? No? Oh, come on. Let's go through here. You can't. Trying to find the last position. There's somebody right below me.
Huh? Get the
I lost
fuck
him
now.
Eat this.
Let's tighten Let's the noose.
You were saying? There must be a lot of O'Neills. There's a lot of them you have to kill in the single-player game. All right, let's make our way out here. Where's the front door?
Yikes! Sorry.
Had enough of you.
One more around the bend.
Holy crap.
Who's shooting? Okay, client is still alive. Let's get back to the bike, which is where? Right here? Somewhere right here. Where's my bike? Oh, there it is. He is camouflaged. That's the story. It's a... Okay, we got 21 minutes to get away here. Having killed most of the O'Neills, not all of them. I wonder where the safe house is. Oh, we're being chased? Well, let's get away from that. I think we outmaneuvered that one. I didn't know they were going to come and chase me. That's interesting. I think we're outpacing them. We're going in the wrong direction, but... We're on a motorcycle. We can fix that. Oh, someone's still shooting at me.
Shit!
Don't worry. We got 20 minutes. We can outrun the O'Neills. Oop! Well, it wasn't my fault that guy cut us right off. Where's the client? Okay, we have to get down there. Are those the O'Neills? Oh, there's O'Neills. So we can still fail this. Did they not die? Okay, now they're both dead. Where is... The client's somewhere over in that side of the thing. They're going after you. Alright, you know what? We gotta find the client. I think I've killed everybody now. Oh, what, how do I get down there? Oh, I'm in the wrong... This is a different thing. Return to the client, who is not dead, and his health is not declining. I am getting a phone call. That's just... Okay, so then I had a phone call, and I'm trying to talk on the phone and drive the guy back, and it really should have been easy. But then one of the cars just drove in front of me and crashed the two of us, and the guy got killed, and we lost the mission. So, still have no idea what these are good for. We don't have enough members to start this contract. I don't have enough members to start this contract. I imagine that other one will come back again. We'll have to try the jailbreak mission here. We have to hijack a prison bus. Again, first mission failed because I was trying to do this while talking on the phone. And you'll have, you know, real life intercedes. And I couldn't, like, pause the mission, of course, you know.
Okay, you get to spring these fools before they hit the jailhouse, stop the transport, get them to freedom, and you're going to get paid.
Okay, so where are we going? Oh, this is one of those moving target things. We don't get a path, we have a target. No, wait, that's another, where is the bus? That was another player. Where's the stupid, oh great, you gotta be kidding me. That's if I don't get killed here by whoever person is just strolling along. Which way is that thing going? It's going around this way, let's shoot for around here. Hoping I don't get any bullets from someone trying to get creative here with me. Again, you can see a lot of driving. Mundo driving. Let's drive to the other end of the world. And you know what? I'm pretty sure that if I had picked my MC club up in Polito Bay or something like that... Yeah, guess what? Probably go... Oh, no, we can't go. This isn't that road. It's the other road, right? I have to go this way and down and underneath and around. Okay. I think it would still put it on the other end of the world. It makes it makes you drive, which really, if they stick to the way that the payouts normally go, that should mean that we get a lot of money, but we'll see if we get any money. The good news is that there's no upfront investment on these particular missions, so if it fails, well, you're out bullets. Well, let's see, that should, I tell you, that last one, if it wasn't for the phone call, I would have been successful, yes. As it was, that guy fell off a bridge, and then I had to go try and shoot some more bad guys, and then someone else just crashed us, and then it was all over. So, we'll do it again. We'll get that mission back, I'm sure. Now, the idea is you can do these missions while you're waiting for your businesses to charge up. You know? As you're waiting for your stuff to be produced, your cocaine and your weed and your forged documents. Okay, we'll just keep moving. At least we're moving in the hopefully the right direction. Truth be told, this would probably be a lot easier to do in my armored personnel carrier, but it's, you know, my insurgent. But we'll get there faster on the bike, and we do only have like 25 minutes here. And you have to cover so much territory. That's one of the reasons I'm using the Hakachu here. It is still have the fastest top speed of any bike. You know, the Hakachu Drag is now the new super fastest around a racetrack bike. Which, it's $1 million, and you know what? It might be worth it, but I'm going to wait and see if they don't nerf that one. Pistol, flare gun. Oh, here we go. There it goes. It's past us. So ignore the purple. And in the middle of the night, take out the cops. And you knew this was going to end poorly. And I've crashed. This is going to be a lot of stars, isn't it? Hijack the prison bus, so I have to get into it. Oh, yeah, you can't jump into it, apparently. Oh, wait! They stopped! Drive! Makes me wish I didn't shoot the tires. So there's a tip. Don't shoot the tires out. This is not a fast bus.
Hello, bravo!
Hey, pendejo, you know where you're at?
Oh, great. Now I got someone griefing me. Oh, come on, dude. I'm on a mission.
All right. You're so fucking dead.
Can I shoot out the back? Am I shooting all the prisoners? Oh, gee. See, that's what happens when you're not looking where you're going. The road drifts a little bit. We got cops ahead of us. They have lights a flashing. At least I'll have a tougher time seeing. I don't know if I'm throwing them or not.
Shit!
We do flare guns? Every time I'm looking behind me, you know, trying to shoot a flare gun out the back.
Cabron.
were stopped for some reason. Okay, so this flare gun doesn't seem to be doing me very much good. Micro SMG.
You're gonna die here.
Yeah, it's kind of looking that way, but do the escape helicopters have to be this far away? We have a bus that can't do 30 miles an hour. Is that the whole deal? I guess like I said, I wish I hadn't shot the tires out. That's a local citizen trying to make a citizen's arrest.
Let's fucking go!
Oh dear. We're driving into a river. I don't know that that was the plan, but it might work for us. Because who knows, maybe this will help us lose the fuzz, you know what I mean, man? Didn't expect that! Ha ha ha! Down in the water. Okay, so my mistake. Yeah, they're still shooting at us, but they overcommitted though. Now we're on the road and they're not. So, ha ha, ha ha! I see. And I just looked down. Oh dear. I looked down for a minute to see if my mic was on. Brakes.
Shithead.
Yeah, I know. That was... They're gonna close on us if I don't... This better be a lot of money. This is a lot of work. Okay. Oh, here they come! They've caught up. Pull this over. Pull this over. Oh, I minimized it again. And we're stuck. We're like so completely stuck here. Can we push this thing out? Can we get in this car? And use it to... Okay, we have like a hope. I know what you're saying. What's the hope? That is really wedged in there. Can we back it up and ram that sucker out of there? I'm trying to get the prison bus to where it's useful. This isn't working, is it? Okay, but did we jostle it enough that it will now back up?
You're gonna die here!
It looks like we're all gonna die here.
Where's the goddamn cover?
Come on, back it up.
Woo-hoo!
I don't know that they even intended for you to get this stuck.
Say, get low.
Okay. This is what we call a bad idea.
Give me some cover.
Well, this is fucking awkward. Oh,
okay, I want you to think this is a good idea. I'll put it on the bus. You put it there. Okay, so we got blown up. Oh wait, we were trying to jostle it out of there and that didn't work. And somehow we still got $4,000 for that.
So, that didn't work out so good. Chalk it up as experience.
You think? Okay, so not off to a glorious start here so far. No. Blah. Stop smoking these rubber cigars. Now you can see too, just from the basic nature of these, how much easier it would be if we had more people. 9/10 of the law, jailbreak, and let's see. That's the same one. Meticulous hit squad, target and tool will be specified. That looks annoying. That will be, so we have to wait 8 minutes for that to come about again. 55 seconds of that. Let's do the time warp again. And then we don't have enough members to do those other two, so we have to wait the 6 minutes before we can do this one. But again, through the magic of technology and not recording this stuff, we just wait. Okay, so let's try this again.
Free these idiots? They're en route to the penitentiary. Stop the bus and let them out before they get there.
I have no idea what happened to my truck there, but I'm not above cheating here. I mean, I realize I should be using a motorcycle. It's a motorcycle gang thing. But if you're going to knock a bus off the street, use something that can knock a bus off the street. Interesting. Now it's a little closer this time. Well, that might work for us. Okay, here we go. Try 2 on hijacking the prison bus. Let's see if the insurgent makes it a little easier. Oh, that's up this way now. Let's ignore the little purple thing. We gotta keep moving. Where did it go? Where is it headed? Head up this way. We'll try to cut him off at the pass. At least if I get grief this time, they'll have a harder time with it. Hard to say if I'm close or not without kind of interrupting and going to the map. Let's see, where are we? It's going up this way. Let's set it for a cut them off at the pass up here somewhere. Get back on the highway. Now where is it going? See, this kind of stuff, it's a little easier when you have an armored personnel carrier. You just drive over people. Okay, we gotta hijack it from the prison?
Hi! I don't lose.
Drop your weapon,
Al! No way!
Don't worry!
Oh, that time to reload, you know? Excuse me, I have to hijack this prison bus. Not hopefully getting too killed. Should have moved the police car. Let's see, let's... And it's kind of appropriate that you're screaming, but... I'm gonna turn this thing around in the parking lot. Oh, here we go.
Yeah.
This thing does not do well off-road. Oh, it's stuck good. Again?
That's for real.
Woo-hoo. All you got?
This can't be happening. It literally can't be happening. Okay, fine. This time we have another option. This time we've got another option. This time we can move the bus. And that's why you bring an armored personnel carrier.
Where you from, mister?
Fuck that shit up!
Oh, hell.
Do not get it stuck again! Do not get it stuck again! That would be really great if we could lose the fuzz. What do you think I'm trying to do here? See, bring in the APC, it was a whole... We have a tire down? 21 more minutes left in the mission before we fail it. But I think now that we're driving, we just keep it on the road. Drive it to the escape helicopters.
Fucking punk!
Are they yelling at me or are they yelling at the cops? Hello, Mr. Policeman. If this isn't worth at least $25,000. It's just not worth it.
Now you're talking.
Let's just aim straight at him. This is such a long drive from the prison to the helicopters.
This is a ball.
All that all you got?
Here we go. Damn.
That's a potential club right there.
Mark, get the hell out of here. Hell yeah.
Hey, look at that. That's an actual maneuver they use. And take the front end off that one. Should slow them down.
I
like it.
Cop sucker. That's for real.
Cut on the inside. That took that cop out. We haven't got a lot of momentum now, though, so we're gonna have to target carefully.
Oh, hell.
Oh, what was that guy doing? He's not a policeman.
Damn, man.
This is getting redundant. Okay, we missed a turn here somewhere. I think we can cut across this way. And a new route. Alright, thank you, Magellan, or whatever this is, and we'll...
The Gunner is home. Where you from, mister?
We're going to the Helioque chapters. That's all. Hopefully we can lose the cops at some point. Yeah, I don't know if we can lose the cops. We were in a prison bus, so I mean, you know, first of all, it's kind of obvious what we want to do. And it probably has some kind of tracker in it, I would imagine. And we're just going to keep driving and driving and driving and driving and how far we have to go. How far do we have to go with this thing? Can we get there in 17 minutes? A cop's out ahead of us, running away. Now they're going to be tailing us. But we got a straightaway so we can open up with some serious heavy duty. There we go! I think that's just a panicked citizen. That wasn't a cop. Where is the cop?
Goddamn!
Oh, there they are. It looks like they're spinning out and crashing into each other. Let me help them out here.
Fuck that.
I think I got the driver. Yeah, another one to... we have to get down to the beach.
Now you talking.
Damn, man.
So I'm thinking this is good.
Asshole.
Yeah.
There. Now, if I don't flip the bus over... $24,500.
Wow. We're done. Good work out there. Party at the clubhouse, because you're getting paid.
$24,500. Oh, and we got one dead prisoner.
Did you forget about Simeon? Come, surely you need me. Call me.
And I can't steal the bus. Well, hey, we only lost one prisoner. I mean, you know, that's... sorry about that, dude. We did our best there, you know? All things considered. So... okay, let's talk about that. We made 24,000 there. And normally it would take me about 24,000 in about a half an hour doing this particular race, just letting it park for a little while and then finishing the race in 8 minutes. 24 minutes if you really crank through it, or for in actual racing time. A little bit more in loading time. This is obviously a lot easier because for at least 5 minutes of it, you're just letting it sit. So, is it competitive with this? If you could actually perform the thing on the first shot, absolutely. They are competitive missions, but, you know, there is a somewhat high fail rate there, at least. Maybe once I get good at them. We'll see how it goes. We'll keep trying to put some of these biker missions up as their own videos. As things go along. But again, watch this. This is just 8 minutes of racing. Boom. $8,000. So, I mean, you do 3 races, you've got as much money or a little more money than you did in that whole kind of... Well, I think, well, you get $4,000 for something else. You get some minor prizes on there. So it's competitive. I'd say it's competitive. It's just what you feel like doing. That was part of my daily objectives. So there's only one other thing I want to do for this video. I hear somebody typing vigorously. Come on, let's load. Natural Green Man. The heck is that sound? Is it timing? Let's go buy a shirt. That's not a request I usually... Let's see, where's the closest shirt place? Here we go. Oh, it's real close by. The last thing I want to do is go buy a shirt.
Oh! See, James? You so easy, James.
I'm not even there.
You so easy, James. Shut your ass up.
Did I walk into all the 5-year-olds today?
Oh, looks like we got into an interesting session. And no, I'm not gonna go blow up that guy's cargo. I don't care what I get out of it. Somebody here. Suburban kind of thing here. Where's t-shirts? Now, somewhere here, special tops, unlocks, showroom t-shirt, t-shirts. Somewhere we're supposed to get a special Western t-shirt. And, you know, I found trouble getting stuff before. Oh, here we go. We're... Ooh, biker t-shirts. It's gotta be in here, don't you think? There should be one that's free. Is there nothing that's easy here?
What the heck is this?
Come on, there should be two Western t-shirts. Western. Why Western? Come on. Western...
What?
Exactly. Special tops. Manufacturer logos. Here, under manufacturer logos. This is... Now, this is one everybody can get. All right? The Western kind of thing. We'll take off the thing here maybe in a minute. But the Western logo black tee, that's the one we want. Let's go to sports jackets. No jacket. There you go. So this is the special shirt you can get if you buy the bike I have outside, which is the Nightshade. Actually, not the bike I have outside. That's we have the armored personnel carrier outside. But this is the one, the Nightshade, the one I was showing earlier. That the red and black and stuff shirt here. Are there any other really cool biker shirts? I mean, obviously this is the one you wanna wear because it's like so cool and like so free. And well, let's go to biker. Let's go to tops. Come on, where are we at here? Where's the t-shirts? Where's the biker t-shirt? There are biker t-shirts.
So we give me that bounty, bro. Give me that bounty, bro. Give me that bounty right now, bro.
Okay. Ride free.
Give me that bounty, bro.
Practice safe sex. Go F yourself. Okay, that's no regrets. For the win! Or F the world, but for the win!
Let's see.
I think we're all gonna take that as for the win, don't you think?
I'm
gonna buy the for the win. Dillagaff! I don't know. Complaints department. Say hello to my complaints department. I like that one. That's a good. One percenter.
I don't know, but I'm reading your mind. I just know, I just know the way you dress. If I don't wear like some jeans, I don't know what type of jeans, and some Jordans.
Yo, what's going on, bro?
I don't know, that's what I thought.
By the way, this isn't on my side, that's in the game. What you're hearing there with the people talking about jeans and stuff. So what kind of jeans you're wearing? The jeans, you know? We go to manufacturers. Let's just go to t-shirts. No, special tops, festive tops. Where do we sign that other one? Tops. Yeah, let's go Western here.
You laugh like a bitch. Shut up.
That's nice.
That's the most common word in every player's vocabulary.
Let's go. Let's kill.
I own one of these. Where's the one I own? There it is.
Sorry, if I serve you, my parole officer will have you for dinner.
Oh, what's going on there? Well, I know you could get shotgun in a shot in a shop while buying a t-shirt. Didn't know this. Let the griefing begin. Let's see, where are my wheels? A pretty good distance away.
No, I don't think you're
Are you looking at all?
What the heck is this thing? Change.
Oh, great. Looks like those other guys are causing more of a problem.
It's not even mine. But let's go and kill this guy, man. He's inside?
We're almost clear. This is all because I wanted to buy a t-shirt.
I'm going.
The entire world is next to me.
I'm going in.
You guys are trash.
Didn't see me.
You're so garbage, bro.
Look at my PD. Bombia limpia.
Okay, they saw me. The jig is up. Oh, this isn't gonna end well.
Step right into the slump fest.
Yeah, helicopter's on us now. Get to the roof.
Cover
You guys are trash.
Four stars. Well, at least now I got rid of my wanted levels. It's at this point.
What? Oh, they inside.
You calling for some wheels? I'm John.
Garbage.
What, is everyone trying to attack that yacht or something?
The police are doing a better job than you guys.
Where?
Just watching people drive around and just assuming that something bad's gonna happen at some point. Where's my knife? Why did they put it all the way over here? Johnny, on the spot, you're making me crazy. See, now at least you got a nice shot of it in the sun here. I definitely like the look. That's not flames over black, that's flames over wine red. Again, not exactly the same. What's that thing? I got a. Moving targets available. My Fraps encounter was blocking that. Take it to its destination for $20,000. A moving target vehicle is available. Where do we find that? Is it close? Is this it? I'm over here. Shall we try it? Something to do. For $20,000?
Toasty! Damn it! So now let's kill you outside, bro.
It only took you like 12 tries.
I don't care.
I don't care.
That was kind of a cool jump right there.
I think the moving target might be a new thing. I mean,
yo,
yeah, might
what
be a
are you doing?
Deal. Wonder, is it like something big and slow and weak, or is it a bike, or is it, you know, something cute? Something really tough that everyone's gonna have a tough time killing, or is this gonna be a complete waste of my time?
Nah, Mike, you're gonna get killed, Mike.
I have to say, the Nightblade, I haven't modded this at all, and it seems like it handles very nicely.
Oh my god, that's
yeah, I've modded it, and it looks,
but... Like, how did I even know this was a rare red flag? Oh my god. But why
my hair
look like
Yokina Sano? Sorry about that. I just totally forgot. Of course, I'm supposed to... Enter the vehicle. Where is the vehicle? Which vehicle? Ooh, it's an armored Karuma.
Yeah, I'll show you one of the bigger dick.
Oh, and they want to kill me.
You're my man. Así es que tú estás, bro. Yo, let's go and kill.
Let's move this thing.
It's 1 p.m., bro. I have to go.
I've never driven the armored Karuma before. I haven't done that heist. Supposed to be one of the best cars in the game here, so. And the windows are bulletproof.
Nah. Look what we got.
This is a good mission to do because it's very hard to grief it. Of course, if he gets hit with a rocket, then we're done. But, I mean, you know. Now, that's the difference between the Kuruma and the Insurgent. The Insurgent could take a few rockets here, you know? But the Kuruma... Oh, here we go this way. Here we go this way. The Kuruma is pretty invulnerable to bullets, but not explosives. Now, we got 8 minutes to get there. Come on.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
8 minutes and a bunch of crazy people here in the public session. But I am kind of out of the way of things. It's making me go this way and then around the bend. Maybe this isn't a biker deal, because you'd think if it was a biker deal, I'd be driving a bike right now. Oops, sorry, excuse me. Thought I could squeeze that through there, but, you know, you didn't also see a crazy person coming at you and slow down. And there is passing along here. You have to pay attention, yeah? You gotta watch this. See, that guy hopefully slowed down a little bit. This is such a long video. I'll have to see if I can cut some of this down. People think all this video making is, oh, well, you play a video game and you upload the video. No, there's work. Wee, woo. I do like the handling on this car, and the speed we've got going is nice. Where do we have to drive this to, Vice City? Looks like we're almost there. Almost there. I see a big glowing yellow thing.
How's it going?
It goes. Apparently you always wanted a car and you're at the construction site. There we go. Winner! $21,000! That was... Oh dear. I delivered it and now everyone's trying to kill me. And then it blew up. I delivered a bomb. Oh, this is... He must have had some armor. Now, why was that guy waiting there for me? Like, that doesn't make any sense. Was everybody doing that? 2,000 for good behavior.
Deck Republic. I'm just looking now. It's over.
Well, they should be over there. Alright, vengeance will not be mine. I got an idea. Let's do the time warp again. There you have it, folks. This is what it's like being in a gang, I guess. I can't think of a better time to say, this is the Black Knight. Ook Ook.